they do. They smile in your face. All the time they want to take your place. The backstabbers.
Backstabbers.
I keep getting all these visits from my friends. Yeah, what they doing to me? They come to my house again and again and again and again, yeah. So are they there to see my woman? I don't even be home, but they just keep on coming. What can I do to get on the right track? I wish they'd take some of these knives out my back. What they do? They do.
Happy Thanksgiving 2011!
And I want to sue Haiti for reparations and remuneration on the confiscated lands because I'm related to people on the birth of my country and I come from...
And an ambassador, and I come from people who had wealth. And right now I'm a homeless, disabled vet in an abandoned house that's under construction for renovations to be sold, and I want to do. You hit that ping, that is a world appellate court prosecution. Come on, Howie, I need a shot. On deal or no deal? Why didn't you call me, ma'am? Okay. I don't want to hear nothing anybody got to say. Everybody, I'd like to introduce you to Mommy Aja. That's the woman that took me, accepted me, and forced her family to accept me because I'm such a no good guy. They took a lot of patience for these people to accept me and love me and feel something for me. And for Marina to feed me, but Marina won't feed just anybody. I mean, she cooks so good, it's beautiful. But if it wasn't for this one.
You need this pacifier like this.
I don't need no pacifier. I'm not 10 years old. Get out. If it wasn't for her, right now, I'd be on Skid Row. My life would have been lost. That's been part of harvesting relationships. And this woman done more for me than anybody since my mama died. And she was loving me long before my mama died. And my mother refused to die while she was while you was working. She died after you went home.
Before I came to work.
Before you came to work. They told me she died. Whatever. You know what? My mother told me that she was doing what she was doing, all the good and giving people all the stuff, because she was making a way for me. And I told her she was crazy. I said, you're giving everything we got to everybody else. That's why I got to give you and I put all that stuff in that house. And they took everything. And guess what? It doesn't matter. Why? I'm not attached to the material. I didn't need it. What am I going to be carrying that stuff? I'm going to get a wife and be happy. I'm going to buy my own stuff. So I'm happy. And I want to thank you, cuz 2011, this is the last year that I'm personally poor, because next year I'm going to get revenge and kick everybody's ass and bring you their asses as trophies so you can be proud of me, because you're a kick-ass mama yourself, just like all the great, and you love when your boy go out and kick the ass. Give it to me, Dad. Yeah, go. Come on, Dad. Do it one more time. Come on. Give it to me. Bang. Boom. Yeah, Dad, Mom. Yeah, shake it, booty. Shake it, booty. I'm the happiest guy in the world. Yeah. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody on YouTube, Twitter, Blogger. This is the last show. This is all for now. I'll see y'all later. Bye.
Tom Crater. You see the homeless? I'm showing them to you on the train. Congratulations, Tom.
Everybody, it's Dr. Philip Drags. I'm homeless. This is my house. I'm just now getting up. It's raining cats and dogs out here. This is my home. I slept out here last night in order to show the world that I am the king of homelessness, to bring to accountability elected officials who've neglected us. This is my house. This is where I live. This is it right here. All right? Are you happy now? Are you happy? Are you happy?